This pavilion is called the capsule. It's a bit of cosmic enclosure within the exhibition space. It leads to early 70s, in the actually peak of cybernetics and system theories. And the material presented inside is a work of Croatian architect Branko Petrović, who published a study in 1971 that is called The Systematization of the Phenomenon of Human Environment. And that's a book, a study, a theoretical piece with 36 spectacular diagrams that connect human systems, social systems, natural system, environmental, like ecological systems, and technological systems in one visual overlay. This particular diagram is one of the six diagrams within the series that discussing spatial categories. So this space is not just architectural, physical space, but also space of infrastructure, space of data, space of total technological immersion. So all of this was projected, visionary projected, and somehow futurologically designed in this series of diagrams, and specifically these diagrams of space. This particular diagram is evolutionary indicators of the social system, and it discusses the future of society when society is completely immersed in technology, when technology becomes environment, and when environment becomes entirely determined by technology. This book from 1971, in a very spectacular way, unfolds this future that we're living in at the moment. There is another important thing why we have this book here in Stockholm today. So the study was published in 71, which was a year before one very important event. That was United Nations Conference on the Human Environment that happened in Stockholm. That was a pioneering event, really. And in that event, there was a declaration, that first declaration on human environment, that actually in, I think, 26 chapters defined preservation and actions, how to treat, how to protect environment, how to sustainably develop and step into the future. For the first time on a planetary scale, we were thinking about technology, environment, pollution, and actually crisis. At that time, from today's position, was not that significant. Today we have the same discussion. We have the same set of problems, but which are much larger and much on higher scale than it was in 70s. So meet Homo effluviens. Well, instead of Homo sapiens, this is Homo effluviens. Homo effluviens means man of a toxic flow. So not man immersed in data, but in toxicity. And toxicity, of course, can be data, can be information, but also can be like a regular environmental pollution with everything that we are surrounded. That's our common environment. This is not an alien. This is a regular guy, like any of us. Actually, this is one of us. And actually, this is maybe us exactly. Because this is this was designed in 72 for the year 2000s. So this is the human of the future, and future is now. He has huge butt because he's sitting all the time, you know, working. He doesn't have any muscles because he's not using his energy and strength and body in the way to develop muscles, because he's, you know, just like on his computer. He has, of course, huge head because he has a huge brain, because he's just thinking all the time about stuff and processes. But the most important thing is this finger. It's called spatulative finger. And it's enlarged because, and I quote, the main preoccupation of the future human is clicking buttons. Or, and I would add, swiping screens. So this is swiping swiping finger, visionary designed in early 70s. My project was to bring this work 50 years later to Stockholm and open it up to people to see it and actually to try to think through it in a new way.